गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ़ यू, माई सेल्फ संदीप पाराशर एंड आई एम वेलकमिंग यू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस 9th क्लास. लास्ट डे वी आर रीडिंग यूनिट फर्स्ट कम्युनिकेशन. इन दिस वी आर रीडिंग एलिमेंट्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन साइकिल. आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू वी हैव सम टॉपिक इन एलिमेंट साइकिल. मैसेज, सेंडर, एनकोडिंग, कम्युनिकेशन चैनल, रिसीवर, डिकोडिंग एंड फीडबैक. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी राइट आवर मैसेज. आफ्टर दैट वी सेंड दिस, सो वी बिकम ए सेंडर. आफ्टर दैट वी इनकोड दिस मैसेज इन द डिजिटल लैंग्वेज. आफ्टर दैट कम्युनिकेशन चैनल टुक दिस फ्रॉम सेंडर टू रिसीवर. रिसीवर हु रिसीव द मैसेज. आफ्टर दैट डिकोडिंग, बिकॉज आवर मैसेज ऑल्सो कन्वर्ट इन अनदर लैंग्वेज. फीडबैक, वॉट इज द रेस्पॉन्स, सो वी विल डिस्कस टूडे. सेंडर, ए सेंडर इज ए इंडिविजुअल और ए ग्रुप हु हैज एन आइडिया और इंफॉर्मेशन विच ही वॉन्ट टू कम्युनिकेट विथ अदर्स. द सेंडर सेलेक्ट द चैनल बेस्ड ऑन फैक्टर लाइक नेचर ऑफ द मैसेज, द काइंड ऑफ द ऑडियंस एंड द सिचुएशन. द सेंडर बिकम द सोर्स ऑफ द मैसेज, source and destinations. Sender is the source and receiver is the destination. Message, it is encoded idea sent by the sender. The message could be verbal, written, spoken or non-verbal as body movement, gestures, facial expressions, eye contact. The message in the example is what the father wanted to convey, reach tomorrow. Encoding, translation of an idea into a message by the source is called encoding. The message may be encoded in any combination of mutually understood words, sign or symbols. The symbols or sign used must be clear to both the sender and the receiver. Communication channel, this is the mean through which the message travel from the source to the receiver. Channel could be either oral or written. With the advancement in technology, visual channels are now becoming more common. The standard channel these days includes wide conferencing, video chat, telephone. These are channel. Written form, email, WhatsApp, messengers, memos, letter, reports. Example, the message is sent through an email, which is transmission channel. WhatsApp, email, phone call, they are communication channel. Receiver, the person or group that receives the message is known as the receiver. The receiver is the one who decodes or interprets the message. It is important to note the meaning of the communication is what is interpreted and not what was intended. Any error on the part of the receiver may make the communication ineffective. In this story, the son is the receiver. Yes, father sent the message. Then son is the receiver. Decoding, I said encoding and decoding. This is the process of deriving meaning from the received message. The message should be worded carefully so that the receiver easily understand. It will change in receiver's language. Feedback, the cycle of communication is complete when the sender receives the feedback from the receivers. Means if I send you message, how are you? You give me response, I'm fine. This is the feedback. Without feedback, the sender cannot confirm if the receiver has interpreted the message correctly. Without your answers, I can't got it. You read the messages or not. It will come in the feedback. After this, barriers to effective communications. We have some barriers. They affect the communications. A barrier to effective communication is any factor, individual, situation or environment that prevent the receivers from receiving and understanding the message accurately. Some of the significant barriers are guided by the nature and purpose of communication as well as the relation between the sender and receiver. Environment barrier. Environment barrier means physical conditions. Sometimes we don't have network, poor lighting, instruments, our phone is not working, our mobile is not working for getting mail. situational barriers for factors like distance, noise. Sometimes if we are in the long distance but network is not coming, so how we get the message? Noise, distractions causes unnecessary dispersion in the communication process. Individual barriers. Some of the individual barriers are as follows. Attendial factors like age, gender, lack of interest, discomfort with the topic, culture and socio-economic or professional status define how a listener perceive and interpret the message. Sometimes our age is not comfort with the message. In the age of 70 we can't got it English if you are not comfortable with. Linguistic ability, we can't read. Speech disorder or other physical disability can distort the communication process. Additionally, the lack of proficiency in the language affect the interpretation of the message as well. In attention, sometimes if you are not giving attention on the sender's message, you can't receive the message properly. If the listener is preoccupied or distracted or just not interested in the conversation, he will likely be not attentive. It may result in an adverse effect on the outcome of the communications. Emotions state. Emotions of the sender at the time of encoding may result in the uses of wrong words or tone that may lead to miscommunication. Likewise, the receiver may misinterpret the message due to his emotions. Sometimes we are not feeling well, so we can't recognize it properly. My unit first, chapter first is completed. Now, some question in this. First question, what is communications? I already told you. What are the features of effective communications? List the barrier to effective communication. Explain any two. Right now we reading. This is enough for you. My chapter is completed. Thank you. Stay at home. Stay safe.